every month or twice a month, some anonymous story would appear, or stories would appear, that it went to the extent of saying that I am a central committee member of CPI Maoist. And another story would say that I'm the person behind planning the military operations, entire military operations of CPMOs. All kind of bizarre things were floated. So Arundhati, in fact, also wrote in her essay that all of us were in fact expecting that there is some kind of an attack on me, either arrest or something or the other. It was not unexpected, because there was a kind of one-year concerted efforts by the intelligence agencies and the police to plant stories without giving any sources or something like that. So in that way, some kind of crackdown will be there on me, was the intent. But the way in which it was done was not expected. You know, like 1,000 cops swooped on into my kind of house, around the house. And then first there was a raid on my house with 1,000 cops were brought all around with machine guns and AK-47s, terrorized the entire campus and enter into the house, about 50, and locked from inside. And they locked us in one room, all three of us, my wife and my daughter. That was the beginning, September 12th, 2013. So, in the name of I can have a very illegal thing that, you know, somewhere some article or object was stolen in the Maoist area, and they are looking for that object, which is not described. And they have the suspicion that that particular object was hidden in my house in Delhi, on the Delhi University campus. So they came with a warrant to that kind of that object. A magistrate passed an order for a search of an object which was lost in Aheri in Gachuri district, interior forest area. And that object is there in my house. That is the story they came up with.
They didn't describe the object.
There was no description of the object. There was no case of theft of the object, and suspected persons, or whom the particular object belonged to, nothing was there. And it was called an object was stolen in the forest area. And that was the reason shown to raid my house. And that raid was conducted with 1,000 cops. Then again, 9th February 2014, another round of attack, and they came this time to interrogate me, and they interrogated me for 4.5 hours. Again they came with about 1,000 people, and then my students, my colleagues, they were all present. Earlier also, when they came to know, they were also present, but they were kept outside the compound of the university accommodation. There was a wall and gates. They were not allowed to come inside. The cops were inside this time as well. And the interrogation took place for 4.5 hours. And then 9th May 2014, they abducted me on the way from my examination center to my home while I finished my evaluation and was coming back for lunch. I had to go back again. In fact, I was the chief examiner. On the way, I was abducted, and then one day later, they announced my arrest, and they took me to Aheri. So that is, the way in which they did all these operations of conducting raid on my house, coming for interrogation, and then the arrest also, they did not follow any legal procedures. And then they did with this kind of hangama. There was a case already on Hemishra, one of the students of JNU at that time. I was implicated in the same case. The case, there are five sections of Unlawful Prevention Act, and then Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. And one section initially was 120B. So later on, by the time they arrested me, they removed 120B and they kept only five sections. So what the reason for that is, removing 120B is that sedition section is already there on UPA, Unlawful Prevention Activities Act. One section is already the same as the Sedition Act section. So that sedition is there already included in that. So I was implicated. In this case, first, Hemishra was arrested, and later on, two Adivasis from the area where they are showing the crime is being done, that is Gadchiroli, Adivasi Maoist area, two Adivasi boys were arrested from there. And later on, after a month or so, Prashant Rahi was picked up from Raipur while he was doing some court case, and then as an activist. And then again, one Adivasi boy from Chhattisgarh was brought and implicated in this case. So I was implicated in the case 9 months after the case was actually, the arrest of the people were arrested and implicated. The charges are all, in fact, one is guilty by association, that I have links with Sipahi Maoists. Section 10 is membership of Sipahi Maoist. Section 20 is guilty by association. And then Section 18 is the sedition. Then Section 38, all these are related with, supposedly I have links of various ways in which I have communicating with Sipahi Maoist and their leadership. So the description, if you go into the description, at one place they say that I am writing letters to them. And then they produce some letters also. The type letters without my name or anybody's name, they produce some letters to that effect. And then there is a fictitious name given in two letters. And then one or two letters from the side of the Maoists. Again, there are no names, but some fictitious name is there, one letter. And they are all type letters. There is no handwriting of anybody in this. That is the allegations showing the links with the Sipahi Maoists. Apart from that, they also claim that I have email and internet chats with the Sipahi Maoists, but they have not produced any chat records or anything. But they just simply say this in the FIR. And in various places in the charge sheet. Most of the material, apart from these letters that they created, the rest of the entire charge sheet is filled with the material taken from the different websites. The statements of Sipahi Maoists or some document, this and that, which are all available in the in different websites, they were all produced as saying that they all were available in my hard disks, which they recovered from my house in the raid. So some of them I might have downloaded, but most of them I have not downloaded also. But these four or five letters, they are showing that these are the crucial material. But in one of the letters, they show is that there is a letter supposedly I had written to the CPM Maoists complaining that I wanted to meet them, but they are refusing to meet me. So referring to this, Mumbai Chief Justice, when he gave me interim bail, he said that what is the problem? They, anyway, they are not they are not ready to meet him. So he only asked them to meet, but they are not willing to meet. The meeting too did not take place. But what I say is that even if I write to them, want to meet, which I did not do, but if I write to them, I want to meet them, that's not a crime. That's no sedition, in fact. Why can't I interview them?
Yeah.
Or why can't I just have a discussion with them? That is not a crime in any case. But that is shown as being a crime, and these are the things which, very ridiculous kinds of things that they build into case, showing their sedition. And then, so by association that I have with the Maoists, through these kind of the flimsy kind of grounds, they are saying that I am an anti-national. See, these are all politically motivated cases. Everybody knows, and including the police, that these charges don't exist. But they wanted to incarcerate people, threaten people, and silence the voices. So, in fact, in my case, the police involved in my arrest and incarceration, and who is also conducting the case in Gadchiroli district, they say that from the very beginning, they say that we know your case will not stand, but our objective was to keep you behind bars as long as possible, and we are already successful. 2 years you are already behind bars, and you are already punished, and our purpose is already served, that you are silenced. What more is required for this case? We know that it will not stand. We know that we don't have any evidence to prove. But you're already punished. That is enough. I mean, in private conversations, the court, when they wait and we also wait for the next date to be given by the court for hours and hours, they say this, all this. Even while I was being interrogated, they clearly stated the object of targeting you is that you will stop campaign against Operation Greenland. So we will put you behind bars to stop you doing this. It is better you choose not to do this campaign, so we will not arrest you. So you give us a word, and we will convey it to our bosses. He will not do anything and he will become silent. So why do you want to face? This is what in the interrogation I was told. So, I said that no, this is a legitimate campaign, and I will continue to do this. You can't threaten me like this. Then you face the consequences otherwise. So whether it's in the case of Binag Sen or Jitan Mirandi or Ajay TG or me or anyone, in fact, most of us who have been charged under sedition. The sedition is the center of this unlawful prevention activities, unlawful activities prevention act. That is the core of this act. So the sedition itself gives the scope to build up frivolous charges. Anything is sedition, in fact. So, you ban one organization and implicate the rest of the people, that is the sedition. And you ban one organization saying that you are anti-national and implicate others in relation with them, association by guilty, that is sedition. So most of the sedition cases do not have any, but in fact in other cases, other than sedition cases, they have to have concrete evidence. For example, you have to be linked with some act of violence, some acts of violence. You have to recover some material which shows that you have either intention or you have conducted some acts of violence. In the sedition, it's a very notional thing, you know, that that you are suspecting to have links with somebody else. This is very notional, it's an idea. So these are frivolous charges and they don't have to show any material, concrete material. So in our case or any other case that we are discussing here, you can see that they don't show any link with any act of violence. So there is, in my case, writing letters, nothing else. I mean, which I actually did not write also. I never wrote also. Most of these cases are like you are cooperating, you have links, you have ideas. So this is the thing. That is the reason why they come up with such frivolous grounds to charge somebody in sedition and branded as a terrorist, anti-national, and then the OPA particularly is Anti-Terrorist Activities Act also is a law to deal with terrorism. And now the number of cases that you can see, most of the cases of this acts of terrorism are in fact acts of having certain ideas, certain notions. So now in this country, the majority of the cases are dealing with the acts of terror are actually acts of having alternative ideas other than what the government or the ruling parties have. Anything other than what you have an idea which is not in the same wavelength that the government in power or the ruling classes, that they are all being interpreted as terrorist activities. See, that was the expectation of the government or the establishment, irrespective of what the party is in power. But I think my arrest has led to wide kind of protests, where more and more people came to know about what I was doing before my arrest, and why should they do this one? It's amazing for me when I came out from prison, the kind of response that came, and people whom I never heard of in remote corners of the country, outside the country, everywhere, they came to know about me and they came to protest. They wrote, so thousands and thousands of people who wrote in the entire world, not only against my arrest but against the government on Operation Green Hand and atrocities in Adivasis. Now any kind of campaign I will participate in against the atrocities in Adivasis will draw more crowd, more people, and more people will pick it up. So they thought that a teacher who is doing some activity intellectually, basically speaking against atrocities and Adivasis, paramilitary operations and Adivasis, they thought that a person in a wheelchair who is speaking about all this is arrested and incarcerated. Nobody else will come out because it's much easier for the government to do the same kind of thing to the others who is not a wheelchair bound. That was the plan of the government, but of the establishment. But nobody, I mean, in fact, had gone back on this or nobody seeing me being incarcerated in with a rigorous kind of imprisonment even before I'm given any judgment for the case. People got infuriated, and then they got more angry, and then they are coming out more and more. It is, the entire objective of this, arresting me and putting behind me bars, completely produce a reverse effects, which they actually, wanted to achieve. Earlier, 2009 to 2014-13, Operation Grant failed because of the campaign among the middle class people and the people who raised their voices. It was basically it came into the public domain. It became a debating point on the TV shows. With thousands of articles written and things like that. They could not do the operations to conduct the genocide. Whatever was done during Salvajadum time, some hundreds of villages were vacated and then people that came to a standstill because of the campaign, and also the campaign picked up internationally. In fact, in the interrogation, I was told that because of your campaign, the Indian government's image was tarnished in the among the international space. So now the government is in a very bad shape. That any forum the government goes. It is getting very uncomfortable questions that the Adivasis are being targeted by you and all that, about the rights of Adivasis. So that shows that it was a successful campaign. And now we have to restart the campaign in a new way to stop this new round of paramilitary and military operations to continue with the genocide of Adivasis. So, in fact, our campaign and the success of our campaign clearly shows that this paramilitary operations in the Adivasi areas is not to target the Maoists. It is very clear, and objectively you can see that in the majority of these areas where these operations are going on or intended to be conducted, Maoists are not there. If it is the case of targeting the Maoists, it would have been only those areas. It is the case of targeting the Adivasis to remove the Adivasis from those areas for mineral exploitation. So this is a larger thing, larger than Indian state fighting the Maoists. So all of us, in fact, those who understand this, at least the democratic minded people of various sections of intelligentsia, should involve and should start a new and a fresh campaign to stop this. That is the only way. I actually got my strength from the Adivasi boys who were also arrested and incarcerated, but wrong. About 70 people were there when I was there. These Adivasi boys who were taken from the remote villages, who do not know anything about outside world, law or constitution, nothing is known. How a jail functions, how a court functions, what is a court, nothing is known. They are just farmers, sons of Adivasis. They are all there. So the jail authorities, after some struggle, they used to give one or two boys to help me from these people who were implicated in the Naxalite cases. They really helped me and saved my life. Virtually, they did everything for me. That gave me the strength. I mean, in fact, I was actually talking for their rights and their survival, and I was talking against the genocide before my arrest. And very interestingly, the same people saved me from the same areas who were incarcerated and was there in the jail. So, I mean, people who, I mean, do not know anything of this could be there in jail for 5 years, 6 years, 7 years, and still they don't lose their sanity, gave me strength to stand up and then fight and do the same thing. Once I come out also, I should do the same thing which I was doing earlier. That gave me the strength. In fact, my students were all supporting me, and they participated widely also in the protests. And these people, a handful of people, some 8 people who claim to be students but not our college, not even except one among them, not even Delhi University students. They are not even students. They were put together by the Hindutva forces, and they were sent to stop my reinstatement. And they claim to be AVVP, but they disclaimed also themselves from AVVP. Later on, when in large numbers, my own students and the students of the college did a counter demonstration against this 8 people, that they want me to back. And these people are outsiders and they should be thrown out. So that became a kind of very counterproductive for the Hindutva forces to send a few people. I mean, you know that in any university, the AVVP is being used to suppress the democratic voices of the students. They are like Salvajudum. They are the private army gangs to being used to suppress the democratic voices that are emerging in different campuses. The AVP itself. In my case, they tried, and but they stopped it after some time because they saw that it was getting counterproductive. But they were not students. My students and students of Delhi University widely supported me. They participated earlier in this thing. And if you go through the number of articles they wrote, it's a huge number of articles, either privately circulated or published on different websites. My suspension is being continued, and that is the latest order.
Oh, when did
that is an illegal order that came just a week ago.
I see.
That my suspension from my teaching position will continue till the case is finalized. That is the order that came in. That is, in many of the cases who face criminal cases, sedition cases, among the central government employees or state government employees, they are reinstated once they are out on bail. But only in my case, separately targeted, and in the entire country, this is the only case where my reinstatement is rejected by a handful of people from Hindutva who were appointed after Modi government came back in my college governing body. So next,
what is the service rules say?
That's what I'm saying. The central government employees rules say that when a person is out on bail, you take him back in the same position. I mean, unless one is proved to be guilty, you cannot punish a person by keeping the person under suspension for a longer time. There is an amendment to the central government rules, employees' rules, that if you don't take a person back, you still have to pay the entire salary. So it is better you take the person back and use the services. Unless a person is involved in a corruption case of the same workplace or a sexual harassment case. In these two exceptions are there. If a person is implicated under criminal charges because of corruption or sexual harassment, they cannot be taken back. In all other cases which are not related with the workplace but with the criminal charges outside, they should be taken back. And there are many Supreme Court judgments. Wherever a person is not taken, Supreme Court gave judgments and reinstated. Unless a person is convicted in a criminal case, you cannot stop a person joining back once a person is
granted
bail and out of custody.
I see. But are you challenging that?
See, the college, some handful of Hindutva forces, vested interest, who have vested interest, they did this. The next step for me is to take the university. My college is not an isolated, separate college. It's a part of the university. University is the higher authority. They have taken this decision without consulting the university, because my college is university maintained college. It's like a department of the university. And they have not even consulted the university. They have taken it in a hurriedly, because they wanted to see to it that I will not go back and join and then raise questions there also, like I used to raise questions earlier. Now the next step is for me to take it to the university and show to the university that these people have violated the university ordinances and statutes, and they did not even inform you before taking any of this decision. According to the rules of the university, the permission should be taken from the vice chancellor, registrar, to take such decisions, but they have taken. So if I don't get justice from there, then I will challenge it.